A few weeks after that dust-up at the OK Corral, I was still after Johnny Ringo. I had tracked him and the cowboys to their hideout at a sawmill, and they were loaded for bear.
So, what exactly did Johnny Ringo do to piss you off?
Well, him and that other bastard.
Roscoe Bob Bright?
Yep. They both deserve to die, and I promise I'll tell you why. But first I need to tell you about the Cowboys' new boss, Curly Bill Brocious.
Herb's coming!
Get ready, boys.
Curly Bill took charge of the Cowboys upon the old man's demise. And after that gunfight at the OK Corral, the Clantons wanted revenge. So they murdered Morgan Earp and grievously wounded his older brother, Virgil.
You shoot the son of a bitch!
Wyatt and Doc went on what became known as the Vendetta Ride, hunting those outlaws down. So when I showed up, that's who they thought I was.
Running low on ammo. Oh, there we go.
There were killers around every corner, all wearing red bandanas. That's how the cowboys identified each other. And I was beginning to wish I had one myself. But I wasn't about to let Ringo walk away unscathed. And that's what drove me forward.
Say that Ringo was infernally fast.
I hardly saw anyone faster, boy. Certainly not Wyatt Earp. That man was all hat and no cap.
Hey, thought of. Nope, can't duel with this.
Earp wasn't much of a match for him, but Doc Holliday might have taken him.
That Lunger should have kept his nose out of it. They never charged anyone for the murder of Morgan Earp.
But everybody knew that Curly shot him in the back. That was common knowledge.
Yeah, maybe so. But Ringo had nothing to do with it. He was just being loyal to a friend.
Is that what you call it? Being loyal? Well, to get to that loyal friend, I had to pass by some buzzsaws as big as a man.
Gonna cut you.
Excuse me, sir. I have a question.
What's that, Dwight?
After old man Clanton died, why didn't his son take over the Cowboys?
Because Ike Clanton was dumber than a box of rocks and a yellow belly to boot. Where was I?
Taking down the entire cowboy gang single-handed.
Indeed I was, Jack. It wasn't easy, as those boys had good cover.
One revolver I want. It's a break action. It's obviously the Smith & Wesson, but...
There were carts everywhere, piles of lumber, and God knows what else for people to hide behind. That really was one hell of a sawmill. Quite an impressive operation. And where was Curly Bill? Did you see him? I'm about to get to that, Ben. Patience. I'm painting a picture here. There was this beautiful waterfall and a crystal clear stream that led to a verdant valley that was truly...
Consider your picture painted. What happened next?
Well, finally the bastards that were still alive made a last stand.
Man, this game is beautiful. I mean, they can make a map this big. How come there's no... I don't know. I'd rather the sawed off. It's just too good at close range. Oh man, whoops, I forgot to... I don't think he would have committed suicide. It just doesn't seem like Ringo would do that.
Curly Bill, Johnny Ringo, and his compadres took off into the lumber yard, and I followed after.
Whoop.
Are you saying they ran? Cowardice was not in Ringo nor Curly Bill's nature.
No, sir. I never said they were running scared. They just wanted me out in the open.
Time to dance with the devil! You working for Wyatt Earp? Did that son of a bitch Earp send you to kill me? Running like a scared little puppy!
Wow, he kills you fast. I feel the sound is still too loud. I didn't really check last episode to see if you could hear me or not, but...
Oh, prove your face, brother!
God dang it. I didn't know where he was. That's probably painful to watch, isn't it?
Come on out, son! Help me out here! Let's see what you got!
Just gave me no choice but to take his life. But Ringo was nowhere to be found.
I knew you didn't kill Ringo, because he was found dead in a different location altogether.
To this day, his killer is still unknown.
Indeed. Took me a few months before I finally tracked his ass to West Turkey Creek Canyon.
Incredible, sir. I always thought that Doc Holliday was the one that killed him.
Sorry I had to ruin the legend for you, boy. But the legend ain't always true. Doc Holliday had nothing to do with the death of Johnny Ringo. I was paid a healthy bounty for Ringo and Curly Bill, and realized there was real money to be made. That's why I went after Henry Plummer. Now, wasn't he the sheriff who augmented his income by shaking down miners and robbing gold shipments? That's the one.
Oh, yeah, I remember him. He ran that gang of thieving outlaws called the Innocents.
So it's true that you went toe-to-toe with him?
Indeed I did, son. Indeed I did.
Man, the Wild West was a neat place for you. Had these giant roaming gangs. They were just, you know, such an interesting place and time in history. You still kind of have gangs today that roaming. Not really
I knew
roaming.
I needed resources if I was going to track down Roscoe Bob Bryant. And hunting plumber looked like a good way to get rich quick. As the local vigilantes exposed him as the leader of the bandits and put a generous price on his head. Plummer rallied his gang to plunder one last gold mine before making their escape, and that's where I thought I'd find him.
Man, look how big that map is. Like, holy jeez.
It makes me nervous standing so close to all these goddamn barrels of gunpowder.
Why would you be nervous? No one has the cojones to come after us. As long as you don't light up a cigar, we're fine.
Besides, George is up there on the rocks with that rifle of his. Nothing gets through here.
Who the hell is that thing?
As my late father pointed out to me more than once, God made men, but Samuel Colt made them equal.
I'm ending you.
All right. That's weird. Look. Watch right there. Ooh. Weird. That's very weird. Is that where it's supposed to go, or? I'm not sure. Oh.
I knew that dynamite wasn't mine, so I decided the polite thing would be to return it. It was the biggest gold rush since Sutter's Mill in 48. Unfortunately, prospectors weren't the only ones drawn to those riches. There were thieves and killers, robbing travelers, and hijacking gold shipments.
You're dead!
Like those that ran with Plummer. Some were just regular folks I knew from town, drawn by greed and easy pickings. Charlie Crow, the blacksmith. James, who worked in the stable. Sam and Jeremiah Barber, the butcher's sons. Ordinary citizens who lived a double life. Stealing and thieving and murdering their neighbors.
This is the one I wanted. Or one of them. There's actually a smaller one that,
Of course, the rest were veterans of the Civil War. Stone-cold killers trained on the bloody fields of Shiloh and Antietam. Bummer had a lot of men on his payroll. A hell of a lot. That son of a bitch pretended to protect the public with one hand while stealing them blind with the other. He set up a defensive perimeter which I had no idea how to breach.
There we go. Now it's golden and great.
You can't beat the innocent!
Dangerous, desperate individuals. I was outnumbered and in way over my head, but I was too damn stubborn and stupid to realize it. They must have thought I was or had some kind of death wish. Seeing as there were barrels of gunpowder everywhere.
Watch out for the goddamn gunpowder!
I thought I was some kind of hero. I finally made it past and headed on to meet my destiny. But first, I had something I needed to figure out. I had a few ideas on how to get into that mine, but once I made my decision, I knew there was no turning back. So my first thought was to enter the nearest mine portal. I saw an entrance. Made sense. It was the quickest way in, but that also made it more dangerous, as there would undoubtedly be enemy pickets posted along the way.
That's not good.
Hey, I'll flank him. Do you know who we are? Come on, that's you, yellow. Time to burn your shit up.
Besides, once you enter a mine like that, it's easy to get all turned around. And that confusing maze of corridors wouldn't even be the worst of it. Some of those shafts could be as deep as hell.
You or me?
A single stumble or misstep can easily end in a deadly plunge to oblivion. Quick reflexes often make up for a lack of common sense. Luckily, I was never one to be easily bushwhacked. I would just need to be careful not to blow myself to kingdom come. With all that gunpowder and dynamite everywhere, a body has to know what he's shooting at.
Had enough?
I do not deserve to die like this!
You can pause and read this.
One wrong bullet could have turned that mine into a dad-blasted tomb. I freely admit that my plan of attack was not just moronic, but clearly insane.
Whoops.
It's a good thing that I abandoned that ridiculous plan before I even tried it.
Whoopsie. I think I was supposed to dodge.
Instead, I spotted a ladder. A way into the mine from the opposite side. It was a long way around, but that approach seemed more sensible at the time. Of course, being I had a problem with heights, that scaffolding scared the bejesus out of me. Climbing down that ladder required some caution, because even though I had a younger man's reflexes, no man can dodge a damn bullet while climbing down a rickety ladder. I needed to make a leap of faith. Which ain't easy when you're suspended between heaven and hell. I was determined not to give up, however. As Sheriff Plummer seemed quite the despicable character. When the vigilantes discovered what the sheriff was up to, people were outraged. That 10,000 they put on his head would go a long way to helping me find old Bob. And I had made it my mission settle that score come hell or high water. But first, I would have to make a choice. Take the elevator or climb the ladder. I wanted to use the element of surprise. Plus, I figured I could use the exercise. I was warmed up already, so what the hell? Plummer was a mad dog killer, and the people of Nevada City deserved better.
Nevada City? Well, I thought Plummer met his maker in Bannock, Montana.
Right. Well, he was the sheriff of both places at one time or another, but that's neither here nor there. The point was, taking him down would save a lot of lives, including my own.
Oh, this is a boss fight. I remember this.
Plumber was clearly unhinged, and I could see right away that this was going to take some doing. That's how Henry Plummer died. Him and his crew were worth their weight in gold. And now, I was officially a bounty hunter.
So, did you finally go after that Bob feller?
Well, I heard word he was in Kansas with John Wesley Hardin. So that's where I went.
Where in Kansas?
Abilene. Why do you ask, Ben?
No reason.
Was Hardin as fast as Ringo?
Ringo was fast, but John Wesley was as fast as the devil himself. Hell, he killed his first man at 15. From that day forward, he had a price on his head and wouldn't back down for nobody, not even Wild Bill Hickok himself.
All right, we're going to end it here. Maybe. Yeah, let's end it here. It's almost 4 p.m. for me, so...
I dodged death many a time, and that night in Abilene was no good.
Alright, we're gonna end it here. This is the revolver I wanted. It's the Smith & Wesson. It's in Battlefield 1 also. Okay, bye.